Hey guys, how's it going? It's Justin here from Simplified Investing. As you guys can tell from this video title, I will basically be covering a rundown of my take on Tesla here, the recent news that we have seen with Tesla, and really where you can expect Tesla heading based on key levels, fundamental analysis, technical analysis, and volume. With that being said, before I get started again, if you are interested in joining our private team to get our daily alerts, our course, and more, feel free to check out simplified-investing.com. We would love to have you guys on board. Finished off another strong day here today, and I will cover what we did trade here after the end of this video. And with that being said, if you do find this video helpful, if you could give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel, that would also be greatly appreciated. So basically, getting started, I'm sure some of you have seen the news. Tesla is going to be included into the S&P 500. Now, what does that mean? This will become part of the SPY or the S&P 500 index and will trade in part of the index. And this has been something that has been going on for a long time. There's been several talks of it happening, and it finally got the news that it will happen here. The biggest thing that we had to wait for was four consistent quarters of profit, which no one thought could ever happen for Tesla, and they continue to prove people wrong again and again. With that being said, you can see how the news affected this today. You get that news of the S&P 500 inclusion here. We're up, pushing up about 9% here, pushing up strong on the day. We did have a sell-off, and I'll cover technicals after going through the fundamental aspect of this, so you guys can get some key levels and take advantage of Tesla on this move here. So the first thing that I mentioned, it will be included in the S&P 500. And why is that significant? Because now it will have a broader range of investors coming into it rather than primarily just retail. The thing that has been driving Tesla all the way back here since we say July, even before that, for the past 3-4 years, is that factor of retail investing. Institutionals thought and deemed Tesla was way too risky to invest in. I can't invest in Tesla, it's way too risky. And they continuously prove people wrong. And now being included into the S&P 500, you will see a lot of institutions start to pile in here. So it gives Tesla a wider range of investors rather than mainly just retail. And this is key because now you will start to see more contracts being traded, more volume, and more people wanting to purchase this underlying equity in Tesla. With that being said, the next thing, the second fundamental aspect with it is Tesla just reported their highest profitability quarter ever. And you can see how the price is acting here. Ever since we started making profits here 4 quarters ago, on 120, you can see how the price has jumped here all the way from 140 to $502. So you have to take that into consideration. This is a high speculative growth stock that has continuously proved investors wrong with the move that it has had, and it has been fueled by beginning traders, beginning investors, and not institutional. Now we're going to see a lot more institutions get into Tesla, for example, because of this S&P 500 inclusion. Now it won't be deemed as risky as it was before. A lot of people never thought Tesla would make profit. It was way too high risk to get into. Now being included in a large market index like the S&P 500, that risk goes to the side as they do deem it more safe now that it is trading on an index. The third thing, is it really removes questions about Tesla and its future. Everyone has been speculating on this stock since it first IPO'd. There's no way that Tesla can be profitable. There's no way that it can turn a profit again quarter over quarter. There's no way it can make 4 consistent quarters of profit. They won't sustain their advantages in the electric vehicle industry. And really what happens is they just continuously keep proving people wrong that, hey, we do have that advantage in this sector. We do have all the key components to running a successful company, becoming profitable, when no one else thought they would. So again, this is another key component that will drive people into this. There will likely be a lot of price target increases on this because of this news, more institutions, more purchasing, and things of that nature. And really, the biggest thing is it really removes that risk factor that some would deem now that it is going to be included in the S&P 500. So that should draw more retail and especially institutional into this particular ticker in Tesla. With that being said, there are a lot of players that are recently coming into the electric vehicle market, We have Fisker, we have NIO, we have XPEV, Li Auto. All these are coming into this, but Tesla, again, the way that they contain that sustainable advantage and competitive advantage is they were the forefront runners in this industry. They maintain a loyal customer base in that a lot of people just purchase Tesla, 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 and really they have the most sound product out there with the most research and development put into it, which is why they have become so successful. And along with that, starting years ago versus starting now, they have really refined their auto and manufacturing so that they can produce these vehicles very efficiently and cost manner that they can actually turn a profit on these. A lot of these beginning car makers like NIO, XPEV, Li Auto, and all these are burning through cash just as similar as Tesla did when they first started. So they have a lot of obstacles to overcome to become the next Tesla in that manner. That being said, having four straight quarters of profit is going to be huge here on Tesla. Number four, the biggest thing is their Chinese development. They had opened that Shanghai factory. And really what this means, and with that profitability, is that the market anticipates that this is going to be a safer investment. It does have a strong future. And the biggest thing is that they're trying to produce 500,000 vehicles by the end of the year in China. So that's really significant, as that will increase their supply of their vehicles that they have out there. And their Shanghai plant is very efficient in that you can really manufacture those vehicles for a lot cheaper, which is why you're seeing some of those price target increases, because they're becoming a more lean manufacturer, which can help them decrease their price of their vehicles. And then the consumers can purchase it and have more sales because it will be cheaper to make and they have a higher profit margin on that. That being said, they're doing very well in China. And the biggest thing that you can take from this before I cover the technical aspect of this is that the management just continuously proves people wrong. Again, as I mentioned, people have thought of Tesla as there's no way they'd turn profit. Thinking about Tesla joining the S&P 500 a year ago would have been absurd. Well, look what they've done. They've consistently proven that, hey, they have everything in place to become successful. And they really are showing people that no matter what people think, they are continuously proving people wrong. No way you can make a profit. Well, they've made profit for four straight quarters in a row. They've always wanted to be in the S&P 500. They're finally being included here. So it just goes to show you how strong of management is running Tesla. And it's really something to consider. If you're purchasing equities or options, you want to have a strong understanding of the fundamental analysis and why is this ticker moving the way it is. So from that, from going through the fundamental analysis side of things, I will now cover the technicals. On Tesla here, you can see this clear defined uptrend here off of these lows at 923. Get this push up here off of 120 in July of 20th. And then we get this pullback here. Now we get this uptrend here that we're forming here. So really what I'm seeing here, so far we still have that sideways consolidation on the weekly chart here. Really what I want to see is a break above this price level here at this region right here. And then we do have that support below at 424. This resistance right here above here at 472.19 is going to be a very key level to break to continue and break out of this sideways consolidation here. So again, starting from 914 all the way to here, we're basically just trend lining in between this 414 level here and this 472 level here. So let's see if we can break through. And once this does break through, it will get a lot of volume behind this move and push this to the upside here. Looking at this from the daily time frame, I'll give you guys some key levels here on Tesla. Really, a key level here that you can see is going to be right up here at this 462 level. And this is what I was watching here intraday. Can Tesla break that 462 level here? Where do you get that level from? Highs back here on 827 before selling off. Highs here on 914 and also here on 921 before selling off. So basically a quadruple top forming here and Tesla failing to take that. So basically what that means is for a run, we need to break this 462 region and then this 472 region with the potential to hit that 500 price point that I have mentioned. And it really, it's going to take some volume behind this. We do have a lot of volume on this inclusion here, but in the coming week, we need to break that 462 region and then that 472 region for a breakout here with a confirmation of a breakout and a continued run over 498.71. Again, we are trading sideways here. A break above those key levels will help us break through and finally start uptrending here on Tesla. Again, key levels there. Let's break out of this sideways consolidation here. And ideally above this 473 region and before that at that 462 region, break through there, push up, gap through this, and then we have potential above that 498 region. We'll likely push to see highs here with that new support provided at 498.71. With that being said, that covers the portion into Tesla. Now I want to show you guys what it's like to get into our private access team, our alerts and so forth. So basically, I'll go into the alerts here. I'll bring this over here. Really, this is what you get, and this is one aspect into everything that we do. You get these daily alerts of what I'm trading. So today, PLTR 16 call at 125, another winning 20% trade here. Same with Boeing, great play on Boeing here today. And really, that's one aspect that you get, but also our course. You can learn from our course, you can learn from our alerts, you can learn from messaging me and getting help, and that's the biggest aspect into this. If you go into the profits here, these will all be members' results here. Started with $100 on Monday, loving this program. Started with $500 on Monday for Ghost. You can really see how we are such a tight-knit community and really do care about your results, and that's really the biggest thing here. Pat O, over $50 here in the past 2 days. I really appreciate it. He has reached his limit. And then we go up here. Ilias Ramirez, up 477. More plays here. Before joining, I thought I couldn't be in profits with the amount of time I have. Now he's finding that he can actually be in profits. Christian here, a great month. And then Jamie here having a huge day, up almost $6,000 here on a $1,000 account. Great day here. And then these are all from the alerts up here. And basically, that's what you get with our team. If you are interested in getting profitable daily trade alerts, that's exactly what we do offer. With that being said, that does wrap up this video. If you have any questions or comments or any analysis on Tesla that you'd like to leave below, we would greatly appreciate it. Thank you and have a great day.